Hello everybody, welcome to this quick webinar about Smart Xset. And just a brief introduction. My name is Samuel Brandner, I'm the product manager, and with me today is Franziska Wilhelm. She will support me if you have questions and stuff like that. This is our agenda. So the webinar will be recorded and sent to you afterwards. We will have a live demo, and afterwards we have a Q&A session. During the live session, a live demo, and the whole webinar, if you have any questions, feel free to type them in the chat, and I will try to answer them. So here's just a quick layer about the advantages of Smart Xset. So it has an intuitive workflow through its modern user interface. And compared to the menu manager, which is a nightmare, it's really much easier. You can automate hatchings with rules. So there's you can create an extensive set of rules to automate the whole process. You also have the preview window in the dialogue that lets you move around like in a drawing mode of Trio. And new functionality in this version, in the version 10, is the distribution functionality. And before, you could only inherit hatchings from other views. So now it's even easier. Okay, I will just show you live on my little drawing here. So most of you should be familiar with this. So when you create a drawing view and you have your first section view, you will have a mess like this. So all the hatchings are confusing and don't follow a linear order. The angle is weird, and also here are two lines. Nobody knows why, but this is just the way Creo does it automatically. So now you have the functionality here in the tools ribbon, Smart Xset. And you can also exit this with the right mouse button. So now you get your preview window. Compare them side to side, you can see. So as much capability as you have with Toolkit to draw this, you can see it looks really similar. So right now you can just select components one by one. Hold Control to select multiple components and just set a hatching here. So for example, four, want only one. You can also set the angle, but there's even a better way to do it. So I talked about rules earlier. So you have different strategies, we call it. So apply rules automatically 135 degrees, copy and distribute. So let's talk about the rules. So if you press this button, you go to the rules editor directly. And here you can see there are some rules predefined. So this one here is if model name contains Dean, exclude. So what that means is if the model name of the component contains the word Dean, then it should be excluded. So as all standard parts, they should be excluded. I also have some more rules in here. So screw, ISO, EJP, so for ejector pin, Auswerfer. Here I have a different rule. It's not based on the model name, but on param string. So as you can see here, you also have the possibility to filter by parameter string, parameter integer, parameter double. And of course, you have to specify the name of the parameter. And again, the criteria, so equals, unequals, contains, Auswerfer, and then exclude. Here you also have multiple options, for example, hatch, double hatch, fill, exclude, erase. So down here, I also have another special rule. based on the material settings. So if the material name equals PVC, then I want a double hatch with automatic spacing. So this auto spacing is also new. It tells the software to create a bigger hatching for bigger components and a smaller one for smaller components. Then, okay, cross hatch is 45 and 135 degrees. And here I have the different line styles I can apply. So just for fun, I did dot and center line. And yeah, that's my rule set. Now I will quickly reopen the to undo my manual changes. Now, if I apply the rules, you can see that the screw here, this component, these two components, they have been excluded. And now I want to clean up the other lines as well. So I just pressed the auto button and it will make it look nice now. So it did just iterate through all the components and gave them the different angles, 45 and 135 degrees. And it also shows the nearest spacing that is available here in my list. So this is configurable. And so that the values are not 3.12345, but close to some numbers. Right. Selecting, I also wanted to show you this. So if you want to multi-select stuff in this preview window, you also have the capability like it is in Creo. If you pull from right to left, then all the stuff inside will be selected. So as you can see, these three components have been selected. And if you go from right to left, then everything that is inside the rectangle is selected. All right, now if you are happy with the with your preview here, you can just apply. And you will see here in the real drawing, the hatching will be applied and only took about 1 second or something like that. So it's really fast. Now I go to my next view down here. So this is this one here. And it would be nice to have all the same hatchings as in this other view, at least for the components that are also cut in this view. So you can easily do that by using the copy command. So just press copy and then you can search for the view you want to copy. So in this case, I want to copy from A. Press OK. And now you can see the hatchings that are found in this other view are copied over. Now I also want to apply the rules to exclude the standard parts. Press this button one more time. And for these two parts here, I want them to have the same hatching. So I select the first one and with Control key the second one. And now when I press hatch, then the settings from the first one will be applied to the second one as well. All right, now we apply this. Yeah, looks good. And now if you imagine you have multiple other views also on the drawing, then it would be nice to distribute the settings. So this is a new function in Smartix Hatch 10. You can now select the components you want to distribute and use the distribute command. And now you can see, okay, this is the view name A, section A on sheet one. And on sheet two, there's also a view, this one right here. And I want to distribute this. So click OK. And I will start the action. And now it's completed. Now if I check out this other view, you can see it got all the hatchings from the view before, except there are some differences because this cut is on another level. So this one is on B, and here's a little cutout on C. So I also need to go back and apply the rules. So it will also unhighlight, exclude the standard parts. And click OK again. Now it looks good. All right, so far so good. So this is mostly what I can tell you about the UI. As you can see, it's really simple and intuitive to use. Just select components, use your actions, so hatch, no hatch, fill, hatching one, hatching two, different line styles. So really easy. And also the offset values here. Yeah, you can also exclude if you want to select different views. Yeah, I talked about these options. I want to tell you about this override menu right here also. So it is possible. So now I changed this here manually. And now when I apply the rules or press this button, it won't update anymore. But if I want that, I can say, okay, override my manual actions. And now when I click the order button, it will override. Doesn't touch the line style, but everything else is undone. Same is for rules. Okay, I would also want to demonstrate this PVZ rule I talked about earlier. So let's quickly go into the assembly, change the material of this plate here. PVC and assign. Right. Okay. And now when I open the dialog and apply the rules, now you see the hatching has changed like described in the rule. To this double hatching, center line and dot. Now I can also apply that if I want to. And then it looks like this. Okay, so I want to give you a little background about the configuration options that SmartXHatch also offers. So I have, so it's all based on some text documents. So the main config file toggles some settings within the software. So there you have, for example, also the possibility to enable this default XHatch spacing and default XHatch angle. So if you set this to yes, then you can put these two parameters in your components within your assembly. If you always create the same models and have the same sections, then this makes sense. So they always look the same or similar. And you just set these two parameters to your desired values. And then when you apply the rules within SmartXHatch, then it will also set the settings according to these parameters here. Then you also have the possibility to set the first rule that applies to be used or the last one. And you can specify where the rule file is located. Here you can also set environment variables to even configure it further. Then you have the possibility to hide or show this override menu I've talked about, where you can override manual changes. So for some people, it's confusing what this does. So you can just disable it as administrator to make the user interface easier to understand for the users. You can also define whether the software should regenerate or not when you open the dialog. So if you set this to yes, then it obviously will take much longer to open the dialog. And if you work with big drawings, you should set this to no. It's mostly for debugging purposes. And this one here, the allowed spacing, so just a comma separated list to give you more option values if you need it. But I think this is a good standard to start from. If you don't set this, then if you set no values here, then it won't, the option menu won't show, and you can have your values whatever you want to. And lastly, we have some color settings. So as you can see in my Creo, I have the dark color scheme, and I also set my smart X-Hatch color scheme to be the same as in the drawing. You can also change that to your liking. And if you install the software, the default will be the same as Creo. Right. So far to the settings. Now to the rules. I just wanted to show you quickly the rule file. So as you can see, this is really simple. If model contains ISO, exclude, and if. So you could add rules within this file also. You don't need to use the user interface for that. Especially if you have multiple rules or hundreds of rules, then you can create them within this text file much easier, I think. And there you just need to know the keywords, spacing, auto area, 20, angle, stuff like that. Then there's also another possibility to chain up these conditions with not or and. So to make it even more complicated, you can do stuff like this here. If you have a really capable administrator, you can try to use these. But if you use them, then you can no longer modify the rules within the rules dialog in the software. Then you will need to do it in the text file. Right, what else is there? I think that's mostly it. So I show the dialog, rule editor, yeah, of course we also have a help where this stuff is documented. Well, I think that's it. So let's switch back to the presentation. Okay, now I'm ready to answer your questions if you have any.
Yeah, thank you, Sam, for your presentation. It was very interesting. There's one question about the availability for different Creo versions. On for which versions is it available?
So the lowest version we support at the moment is Creo 2. I think from M70 or something. But there is not the version 10. For example, the newest one I just showed will work with Creo 4 until Creo 6. So I would recommend to at least use Creo 4 to be able to use the new features.
Thank you. Yeah, at the moment there aren't any more questions. So just write us an email if there are further questions of you.
All right. We also have some more webinars, or only just one upcoming. It's about Smart Assembly or Smart Design Server. Will happen after this one here. And if you want to contact us, you can subscribe to our newsletter to be informed, update our YouTube channel. And if you have any questions about the software, you can also contact me directly at Samuel at uw-software.de. And also, if you want to try the software for yourself, you can ask for a demo license. I'm happy to help you out. So thank you for your attention. And after this meeting, you will receive an email with the recording of the webinar. So if you want to watch it at a later time or share with a colleague, you can do that. All right. So thank you all, and see you in the next webinar. Bye.